Hello everyone, this is Tarun Jagdish. Now in this video, I will be sharing with you the highlights of the budget 2021. Friends, one thing what you need to understand is that every year the budget is announced on February 1st for the coming financial year. Maybe to give you better clarity on this, February 1, 2021, they will give you the budget for 2021-22. Similarly, February 1, 2020 will be the time when they will give you the budget for 2020-2021. So like this, the current budget has also come on February 1st and it has got some very interesting features. Let us go and analyze these features one by one. First thing, the expenditure which is expected in the coming financial year 21-22 is 3.42 lakh crore. By comparing with the revenue, which is only 22.45 lakhs crore. So there is a shortage, a deficit which is coming when you compare the revenue with that of the expenditure, and we have to see how the government takes actions to take care of this shortage. The tax proposal goes like this, current and proposed. If you see, earlier if a person is earning from 2.5 to 5 lakhs, this tax rate is 5%. Above that it goes to 20% and then 30. But under the new slab rate, they have given the rates as 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Maybe to explain to you how this actually works, I would just take a person whose name is, let us say, Mr. X. Assume he is earning 20 lakhs. Okay. Under the current scenario, up to 2.5 lakhs, he won't be paying any tax. 2.5 to 5, on the 2.5 lakhs, you will be paying a 55% tax rate, that is 12,500. How do you get that? 2,50,000 into 5%. Okay. 5 to 10 lakh, he will be paying 20% tax, that will be another 1 lakh, that is 5 lakh into 20%. And on the balance, greater than 10 lakh, if you see, another 10 lakh into 30%. He would end up paying 3 lakhs. So the total tax that he will pay is 3 plus 1, 4. He will end up paying 4 lakh 25,000 under the current scenario. Whereas the same person, if he comes under the new slab rate, the proposed slab rate, where every 2.5 lakhs you see there is a 5% increase coming in the tax rate. Let us check how will be the answer under the new system. Less than 2.5, 0. 2.5 to 5 it will be 12,500. 5 to 7.5 it will be 25,000, that is 2,50,000 into 10%. 7.5 to 10 it will be 2,50,000 into 0.15, that is 37,500. 10 to 12.5 it will turn out to be 10, 15, I believe it is 20%, right? Yes, it's turning out to be 20%, so 2,50,000 to 20% will be another 50,000. 12.5 to 15, that is another 2.5 lakh will be at 25%, that is 62,500. And 15 to 20, on that 5 lakh it will be 30%, that is 1,50,000. So let's calculate how much tax you will end up paying. 12,500 plus 25,000 plus 27,500 plus 50, 62,500 plus 1,50,000. He will end up paying only 3,37,500 as compared to a tax of 4,25,000 earlier. I hope this makes it clear as to how the tax proposals are going to benefit an individual having an income of 20 lakhs. Senior citizens who are only pensioners greater than 75 years, you don't have to file any more income tax. Another interesting factor which has been budgeted or which has been assumed over there is that dividend income will now be taxed in the hands of the recipients. It is not yet confirmed. We have to wait and see for the official notification. Next important budget amendment that they have brought in is that they are going to bring TDS on e-commerce transactions. Friends, TDS on e-commerce transaction is a huge source of revenue for the government. I'll show you an example. Suppose there is a company called XYZ. This company is selling its goods through Amazon. So if Amazon is selling some goods for, let us say, 1 lakh rupees plus the GST amount, once Amazon collects it, Amazon has to pay the money back. At that point, if they deduct TDS, all the details of XYZ will be available with the government And each one of these dealer who is trading through online trading will have to pay all the taxes. I hope you are clear with this part also, friends. That is how TDS or e-commerce transactions happen. Next one is about startup taxation. Earlier, for every startup, 3 out of 7 years they were giving a waiver in profits. Now, 3 out of every 10 years they are giving a waiver in profits. And the criteria earlier, the turnover was 25 crore. Now they have brought it down to 100 crore. Rates on cigarettes, tobacco, etc. has been increased. One of the very interesting factors that is coming is, in order to raise funds, government is planning to do some disinvestment in LIC and IDBI. So there will be an IPO coming up. This is going to have a very positive impact on the share market, because if LIC comes under IPO, a lot of people will be very positive about LIC. They will buy the share and the prices will go up. I will again repeat the overview of the budget. 30.42 lakh crore is the expenditure, 22.46 lakh crore is the receipt. There is still a deficit of how much? Approximately 8 lakhs crore. As far as GST is concerned, these are the major amendments. Any service by a club to its members earlier was not taxable, it was debatable. Now, under the new budget, they have made it taxable. Second, and a very good news for all the traders is that, earlier, up to a turnover of more than 2 crore, you required to file a chartered accountant report called as GSTR 9C. Now, that is not required until the turnover crosses 5 crore. If you are doing some exports, this is something which will affect the exporters a lot. If you don't get money, you are not eligible for any kind of refund. So, exporting alone is not enough. You have to export also and you have to receive the money also. I would now share with you, using the site of moneycontrol.com, how this share market is getting affected with the budget. Overall, as you see, taxes has come down for the normal layman people. Tobacco taxes has gone up. LIC disinvestment. Overall, this budget is viewed as a positive budget. In fact, the Warren Buffett of India, Rakesh Jhunjhunwala, has also given a very, very bullish expectations on the market. So all this is very clearly visible as far as the stock market is concerned. If you look at this graph, it is very clearly showing, maybe I'll just expand the graph, the prices have gone up drastically. The earlier peak, this is the last 1 month's graph, 12,000 was the peak 1 month back. It crashed down up to 7,000, and after this it started going up again. It went to a peak just a few days before the budget, the prices fell down. But now it has reached the new high of 15,153. So this shows that the budget is having a very, very positive impact on the share market also. I hope you are clear with this video, friends. Thank you so much.